Hello, children. How are my little munchkins? Want to hear a story today?
Hello, Dr. Beaconstein. We are doing great. A story would be fun. A perfect thing to do on a lazy, sunny afternoon.
Yeah, we love your stories.
We sure do.
Once upon a time, there were a mama bird and a papa bird. They had five little baby birds. It was a large family. Every day, either mama bird or papa bird would fly off to gather food for their babies, while the other one stayed home to look after the babies. Whoever had gone out would come back in the evening, and then they would both fill their babies' tummies with food and tell them stories of the world outside. One day, the babies also wanted to go along and explore the world. But Papa Bird did not agree. He said they were too little to fly large distances and would get tired. Mama Bird also said that they should wait a little more till they have learnt to fly well.
Where was their house?
Birds live in trees, in a nest, Emily.
But if their parents left them alone, wouldn't they fall from the tree?
They could fall, but remember, one parent always stays at home until the babies are a little more grown and can take care of themselves. Now, let's get back to our story. One day, both the parents decided to go together to get food, as it was getting difficult for one of them to gather enough food for the large family. The baby birds were growing bigger, and so was their appetite. So Mama Bird gathered her brood and told them to stay together in the nest. She told them to be careful and to not fly out on their own until they returned. The little ones agreed, but winked at each other, for they surely had other plans. Just as Papa Bird and Mama Bird took flight, the five baby birds followed them quietly, one by one. But as they were small, they were soon left behind. They lost their way and started crying.
Oh no! Poor little babies! How will they go back home now?
Mama Bird and Papa Bird felt something was wrong and decided to return home much before the day would end. While going back to their nest, they found their babies crying on the branch of a small tree. They quickly flew to their side, comforted them, and told them that they were not yet ready to go out alone. They said, "When you grow up a little more, we will teach you how to find your way back home, and then you can fly out into the world and explore it."
My mother always said that we need to always go with an adult till we are big enough to find our way back home.
Yes, she's right. Just like these birds, children also live with their parents and sometimes with their grandparents. The elders in the family take care of the young ones and teach them to become independent. We must always listen to our elders and obey them, or else we will land into trouble, just like the baby birds in the story.
And then when we grow old enough, we will look after our parents, as by then, they would have turned very old.
Oh yes, dear. That's very thoughtful of you. A family is a close unit of people who love and take care of each other at all times. People who are related to each other and live together in a house are also called family members. A family can be small or large, depending upon the number of family members there are. I have a small family with just three members, myself, my wife, and my daughter.
In my family, there are four of us. I have my father, my mother, my little sister, and me.
So, you have a small family too. What about your family, Emily and Oliver? Who all are in your family?
We have seven members in our family. Our grandfather, grandmother, father, mother, Oliver, me, and our baby brother.
So you have a large family. In a family, whether it's small or large. All family members live happily together and love and care for each other. We must spend time with our family members and must be helpful to them.
Dr. Beaconstein, I also have a large family, but they don't stay with us. I have uncles and aunts and a lot of cousins, too. We visit them during our vacations, and we have a lot of fun together. We are a real naughty bunch. That's what my grandma says when we are together.
Well, it's nice to know that you love your family. But such a family is called an extended family, not a large family. It does not really matter what type of family we have. What's important is that we love each family member and care for them.
Dr. Beaconstein, my mother says our pet dog Jasper is also a member of our family.
Yes, Emily. Our pets are like our family members. We love them and take care of them, like any other member of our family. So children, always take care of each other and your family, and stay together and no harm shall come your way. Bye!
Bye, Dr. Beaconstein. Thank you for the story.
Yes, thank you very much.